Hi, Chris Wallace from TGW. We're here in Orlando, Florida at the 2017 PGA Merchandise Show. We're with ECCO this morning. I'm with Tom Dixon. Tom, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good to see you.
Thanks.
Tell us a little bit about what you do with ECCO.
Yeah, so I'm product manager for North America. So I kind of liaise between our sales teams and our commercial teams here in the US and Canada, and where our design and our global commercial teams sit in Denmark, and try to make sure that, you know, we get the right product for the market, we get to have the right timing for the market, and that, you know, the USA and Canada really gets some golfer needs for us.
Sure. Now, as a European company in North America, ECCO is still a growing brand. Just, you know, tell us a little bit, you know, for maybe somebody who's not as familiar about ECCO, what they need, what they want to know about this company.
Sure. So ECCO is a family-owned company. We were started in 1963 by Carl Tuesby. So we've been around for quite a while. So we have a lot of expertise in shoemaking, over 50 years expertise in shoemaking. It's still family-owned today. You know, we have, I think, around, you know, over 20,000 employees around the world, all owned by Carl Tuesby's daughter, Hanny Tuesby. One thing that's unique about ECCO is that we own the entire value chain of our production. So we call it cow to consumer. So we own all of our own factories, we own all of our own tanneries. We do all of our production, all of the tanning yourself. So any ECCO shoe that you see, all the leather that comes from it, this leather was done in an ECCO leather tannery. We're actually a big wholesaler of leather too, so we actually sell our leather to a lot of other companies externally. And then every factory, wherever an ECCO shoe is made, whether it's made in port, we have factories in Portugal, Slovakia, Indonesia, China, Thailand, it doesn't matter where it's made, it's the exact same process. We use a very technical process called DIP, direct injection. So it's a seamless shoe, there's no glue or cement, and it's the same process in every single factory around the world.
Outstanding. Now, one thing customers in North America to be aware of and get used to is the European sizing.
Definitely.
For some, that can be a little intimidating, but it really doesn't need to be that way, does it?
No. And European sizing, it's, you know, it's obviously in North America, it's very difficult sometimes to explain to people, but the way that European sizing work is that it's full sizes. So you don't see half sizes. We do it, you know, 41, 42, 43. So you don't see the 10.5, 9.5. And that can be, you know, hard to get around if somebody says, oh, I'm always a 10.5, I need that half size. But the way ECCOs fit are actually pretty unique. So the way an ECCO shoe fits, call it the ECCO Freedom Fit. The easiest way to describe it is kind of use my hand as an example, but ECCOs fit snug in the heel and snug in the instep, and they're roomy in the toes.
Okay.
So you always have a little bit more room in the toe box, but the way an ECCO is going to fit is that it's always going to have that snug heel, be snug in the heel. So even if the shoe is slightly too big from what you're used to, you're not going to be slipping in and out of it because you're going to have that's going to be snug in the heel and the instep. Right, having a little extra room for your toes is never a bad thing, right? Nobody wants to be kind of scrunched
right
in the end. But having that Freedom Fit where it's snug in the heel, snug in the instep, a little bit more roomy in the toes, is a very common European way of shoes fitting. So another thing that we do is actually a lot of our shoes now come with an extra width feature. So you can remove the inlay sole, and then underneath, there's a second inlay sole. And what this actually does, it gives the shoe a little bit extra width, but it also gives the customers a way to play with that half size if they really, really want to dial in that specific size. So if somebody's maybe between a 43 and a 44, take the inlay sole out, and then you kind of play with that half size a little bit too.
That's outstanding. And obviously, another thing that people who own ECCO shoes understand and know and why they keep coming back is you're known for comfort.
Yes. Yeah.
Tell us a little bit. I know one of the reasons is, unlike a lot of companies where the comfort comes from an insole, you've actually got a full constructed footbed within the shoe.
Yeah, that's a very good point too. So the DIP process and the injection process, what it is you sew the last of the upper of the shoe on the top, and then you inject polyurethane into the back of the shoe, and that's what the midsole is all made out of. And when you inject polyurethane like that, you actually build the support and the comfort into the midsole of the shoe. So you can see if you cut this shoe in half, the arch support is actually all this padding that's in here. And polyurethane is very much like a rollerblade wheel or a luggage wheel, a bouncy ball. It has a little bit of give to it, but it always comes back to its original shape. And another thing that we say, you know, people always step in comfort with ECCO, right? People put ECCOs on and they say, oh, this is great comfort, I can feel the arch support. And then to just kind of, you know, prove that point, you take out the inlay sole and you can see the inlay soles in all of our shoes are actually pretty thin. They're very technical inlay soles, they're antimicrobial, they're moisture wicking, but there's not a ton of support in there. And the reason is because an inlay sole that has a lot of support is probably a foam, it breaks down after a while. But when you build it in with a polyurethane, that comfort is going to last for the entire life of the shoe.
Outstanding. Tom, great information. We appreciate it.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thanks for stopping by.